Don't you look lovely?
I'll bet you're waiting for a very lucky young man.
Rick, and I'm expecting him any minute now.
Oh, well, do you mind if I sit down till he gets here?
So, you've been a stranger lately. Why don't we have lunch sometime? Marilyn, what's wrong? Have I done something to offend you?
I think I'll go wait for Rick in the lobby.
It's your father, isn't it? He's telling you all kinds of stories about me, isn't he?
Please, Maria.
Well, whatever he's told you, I'm not a monster. Oh, look, I just want to be friends again. You know, the way we were when you were a little girl back in El Paso?
Things have changed, Maria. I'm not that little girl anymore. And you certainly are not the woman that I thought that I knew. All you've done is hurt the people that I care about. People like Vicky and Clint and my father. He told me the truth about you, Maria. What you did to Vicky and her family. And I will never forgive you for it.
Waiting to take you back to the capital, shall we?
We're not going anywhere, Donner, until you show us cell block K.
Cell block K?
Yes, the one you wouldn't let us see on the tour. We also demand to see the infirmary.
Demand? Does this nurse speak for Freedom International?
I told you, she's our medical expert. If she feels we should see a certain area, it's good enough for me.
Oh, Nurse Fields, why are you so insistent? We've done our best to be hospitable. Don't you trust us?
Unless you let us finish the inspection, Major, then we will take this issue to the World Health Organization of the United Nations.
We do not take kindly to threats or demands, Nurse.
We don't take kindly to threats either, Major. As you know, Freedom International has a lot of friends around the world. And unless you would like Zaroon to remain an outlawed nation...
To prove that we are not the outlaws some would have us, I shall telephone my superiors in the government to discuss your request at once. If you would kindly wait outside.
That sounds like a fair compromise, Nurse.
I look forward to the next round, Nurse Fields.
Marilyn, whatever Tom may have told you wasn't true.
Are you calling my father a liar?
No. No, but he may have exaggerated the facts. I mean, yes, we did have a falling out over Vicky. He knew that I was aware of his feelings for her. When I said that he shouldn't come between Clint and Vicky, he took it pretty hard. I just regret the fact that he's turned you against me, too.
Are you going to sit here and accuse my father of coming between Vicky and Clint when it was you who practically destroyed their marriage?
You don't know what you're talking about, and keep your voice down, young lady.
I was there, Maria, the day that my father learned how you tried to make Vicky look like Nikki Smith. The suitcase that you planted in the trunk of her car, the red wig, the dress. Does any of this sound familiar, Maria?
What in the world has happened to you, Marilyn?
Are you going to tell me that you weren't Allison Perkins' accomplice?
I cannot believe this, that I have to defend myself to you. And how? How can you accuse me of this strictly on hearsay?
I am not accusing you of anything, Maria. And it's not up to me to judge you. I just don't want to be friends with you anymore. Goodbye.
Oh, Marilyn, have you mentioned these outrageous stories to anyone?
Don't worry, Maria. Vicky and Clint haven't told anyone what you did to them. I certainly.
Oh, how you doing?
Hey.
Mary Lane, this is great seeing you two together again. Just like old times, huh?
Yeah. Well, the old times are long gone, Cord. Now, if you'll excuse me, I think I will go wait for Rick in the lobby. Bye.
I guess I'm not the only one who's in a rotten mood today. Oh, what's going on?
That was wonderful.
Wonderful?
Mm-hmm.
When it wasn't the single most exciting moment of your life?
Well, it was all right.
Oh, you're gonna pay for that.
All right. It was stupendous, huh? I promise.
You saw fireworks.
Oh, Roman Catholic?
Yeah. The Earth moved?
Oh, 10.8 on the Richter scale. They felt it all the way to San Francisco.
Oh, that's much better. What?
Isn't me. Max, I just can't help wondering that when we made love, you weren't only thinking of me, you were thinking of that woman you can't seem to forget.
Who's that?
Come on, Max. You want to know what was on my mind? Now I'm telling you. I want to know that when we make love, you're not thinking of anyone else. That there are no ghosts, no lost lamented loves.
No ghosts. Not this time, just you and me.
Look, I'm not trying to control your feelings.
You're not?
Mm-hmm.
What you have done is you've taught me learn how to leave feelings behind. Now I can mourn for love I'll never have. Or I can leave myself open for something new. Something even better.
I can't take credit for that. I think you changed your life all by yourself.
No, no. You've been too modest here. You've encouraged me, you're my new partner. At this rate, who knows what'll be next?
Well, at this rate, I can't wait to find out.
Mm.
Oh, no.
What?
No, 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 not now. Oh. Oh, I'll go. Tell him to go away.
No, no, wait, wait. It might be supper that we ordered. Someone has to eat sometime.
Who says?
I do. Save my place. Give me. Ooh. Bring it in! Yeah, that's great, right there.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Holden. I could have left this outside.
No, no, it's all right. You want, here, hold this.
Great, thanks.
Good. Oh, you want some? Oh, fresh out of pockets. Hold on. Hold on, I think I got something right here. I'll pay the lady back later. How's that?
Just fine.
Great.
Enjoy it, Mr. Holden.
Thanks. Close the door on your way out. Maybe you should find it in your heart to forgive him.
Steve, I could spend my whole time in Landview forgiving people. First you tell me that Tina isn't married to Max. I find out she's married to Cord Roberts. Now today I find out that they're getting a divorce.
I know it's all very confusing, but why are you taking it so personally?
Because I hate to see people make a shambles of their life as I have with mine.
Well, I don't think you have to worry too much about Max. He sort of has a knack for landing on his feet. He also has some big dreams, I'll give him that.
And does he have the money to support these big dreams?
Oh, that's never stopped Max before. If he had to hock his fillings in his teeth to get to the top, I don't think he'd hesitate to do it.
You know, Landview is like Alice in Wonderland. It's nothing of what I expected. A cowboy turns into an entrepreneur. a loving mother and father end up getting divorced. And this torch that Max holds for Tina, for all I know, this is just an illusion, too.
No, Gabrielle, if there's one thing in Wonderland that's for real, it's Max's love for Tina.
But Tina doesn't love Max, does she?
No. She's in love with Cord. Only Max won't get that through his thick head. Sometimes I think that the reason he's pushing himself so hard to succeed is to change Tina's mind.
Well, we all do foolish things for love.
What about you, Gabrielle?
What about me?
Well, you had some strong feelings for Max at one time. Is it still true?
Whatever feelings I had for Max, they were over long ago.
But if that's true, then why did you come here in the first place? You can't tell me that it's just business.
Steve, please, thank you for worrying about me, but I will be fine.
Wait, Gabrielle, you haven't answered my question.
It's Tina who has to answer some questions. She and I are long overdue for a talk. But thank you.
To the Holden Towers.
To the Holden Towers.
Well, now that we have toasted our mutual success, our new partnership, and our new hotel, what's left?
How about a lot of hard work? Max, we've been doing a lot of dreaming here. This is going to take a lot of hard work to make this a reality.
Are these the hands of a working man or a bum?
A bum.
How about this hand? No, I'm telling you this.
Yeah?
I'm not going to sit on my behind and wait for good things to happen. I'm going to scratch and claw my way to the top of the heap if I have to.
Mm-hmm.
I can tell you something. It's going to be a lot easier with you beside me.
Max, we've got to get something straight here.
Look, if you're worried, I'm not the kind of guy that wakes up in the morning and says, thanks, I'll call you, and never does.
Yeah, well,
What?
Look, I've had a wonderful night with you tonight, and I hope there will be many more like it, but I hope you're not thinking that because we spent this time together, we're committed.
You are without a doubt the most unsettling female I have ever met in my life. Here I am worried about breaking your heart, and you're worried I'm going to care too much.
Yeah, well, I just want to make sure we know where we stand.
Well, yeah, I'm just as realistic as you are.
Good. Then we understand each other.
But I am still a bit of a romantic.
Oh?
And I would hate to think that tonight was the beginning and the end of something beautiful.
It is definitely not the end. Now I have a toast. To Max Holden, the new bright star on the financial galaxy. Max, what's the matter? Don't you like my toast?
A question to ask you. A personal question.
Well, you look so serious. Come on, Max. Can't this wait till the morning?
No, no. If we are going to be more than business partners, I need to know more about you.
Well, what?
What is the real story on Carol and Millie?
Oh, poor Mary Lynn. She's having trouble with her father, and she wants me to help her. But, you know, I told her I care about the both of them, and I just wouldn't interfere. Coy? What is it?
I'm sorry, Maya. I just keep thinking about Kate. I haven't heard word one from her since she left for Geneva. I don't even know if she's really got a friend over there who's in trouble. I've talked to Charles, I've talked to Cindy. They both give me the same story. She's over in Geneva. She'll be back soon.
And are you doubting that?
Ma, I talked to her hotel over there. They said that she checked out. They have no idea where she went. They don't even have a number where I can reach her. Now, does that sound like the Kate Sanders that we both know and love?
Well, no, it doesn't, but it doesn't mean that she's in trouble either. Cord, the baptism is over. What you should be concentrating on is getting that divorce.
Please, now, all I have been thinking about lately is the baptism and Tina and Al. What good is a divorce going to do me if Kate is in some kind of trouble and I can't help her? I can't even think about lawyers right now. I'm going to do whatever I can to find out what's happening.
Well, now, wait a minute. Cord.
Where
Well, I'm happy to inform you that one of you will be allowed to view the infirmary as well as cell block K. That person will be you, Nesfields.
We came as a group. As a group, we'll remain.
Oh, it'll be fine, yes.
You mustn't worry. I will personally see that Nurse Fields is driven back to the hotel after she's completed her tour.
I'll be all right after all. I am the expert.
I suppose we have no choice.
Well, excellent. If you would wait outside, then I will come along in a moment and walk you back to your jeep. Nurse Fields will then have her personal tour.
Wonderful. The sooner we get started, the sooner we'll finish what we came here to do.
Business partners, then I need to know more about you.
Well, what do you want to know?
What is the real story on Carol and Millie? Hey, all I did was ask a question.
And I want to know why.
Well, like I said before, I want to know more about you. So come on, what's the deal about this Carol and Millie?
How did you find out about that? Why are you trying to pry into my life?
Pamela, I got you a message. What's wrong?
Nothing really, actually. Everything's just great. Except for a couple more signatures and a couple more contracts. This place is no longer mine. I want you to know I finalized the deal with Max, and thanks to your suggestion, I got a much larger down payment. And I'm leaving for Malacava first thing in the morning.
But you know what? You know what, honey? I could not love you any more, even if I was. Oh, I love you so much. I do. Oh. I mean, I just wonder why your daddy had to leave the party so soon. Yes?
I beg your pardon, Mrs. Roberts.
Oh, well, is Mr. Roberts back?
No, madam. Miss Medina is here to see you again.
Oh. Thank you, Heron. That'll be all.
Very good, madam.
I found out that you've lied to me yet again. I found out that you and Cord are getting a divorce.
He's coming, too.
Almost ready.
Ready for what? Freedom International? Where are they?
Where's Freedom International?
Take it easy, Miles.
Patrick London, you know that.
Jimmy, you're wrong.
No, what do you want to do about it?
Oh, come on, a sedative or a bullet?
Oh. Hey, Amelia!
It's Mildred Donner. I have a nurse from Freedom International out here. Open up.
He's going under. Open the door.
I feel like a speeding freight train has just whizzed by me. You are leaving tomorrow?
That's what it said. The end, no discussion, and please don't argue with me about selling the hotel.
The hell with the hotel? I'm concerned about you. Why are you running off like
this? Asa, I have made up my mind.
Why so quick?
Well, it's the clean break theory. You know, sell it, pack, and get out of here before I know what hits me.
I'll tell you what's hitting me. A whole lot of sadness, honey.
Asa... Will you please just say something very gruff so I will be happy never to see you again?
Never? Damn.
Well, honey, you are never going to drop anchor in Malacava, and I am never coming back to Landview. And that's reality. And as I learned from you, you always face reality with your two six-shooters loaded.
I don't know whether to kiss you or shoot you. But I'll tell you something, there's a lot's got to be said between the two of us before you take off.
It's all been said before. It was the best of years, it was the worst of years. We loved each other, we battled each other, and we lost each other. Millions of songs have said it before, and we don't have to repeat it.
I know you remember. And I see a lot of bravado covering up your feelings here.
Look, I have something for you. A little farewell gift.
The mansion. It's lovely.
Well, you know, actually, I was going to give it to you at Christmas, but I was so angry at you. And then I decided I'd give it to you at Easter, but I was still not very pleased with you then either.
Let's say you're giving it to me now because today's my great-grandson's baptismal day and not because you're leaving.
Fine. But I still am leaving.
Okay. What about O'Neill?
Oh, that's none of your beeswax.
I'd feel a lot better if I knew he was staying here. At least I would know you weren't throwing your life away in that creek.
Well, if you ever drop in on the South Seas, you come see me, okay? And any charitable contributions towards the rebuilding of Malakava will be greatly appreciated. Why, you take care of yourself. You know, I will always remember you.
Is this really goodbye?
Yes, it is. Come on, give me one more giant bear hug and then I've got to go.
Damn, I've got a lot to say, but I just can't put the words together. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to write them down in a letter. I'm going to mail them to you.
Oh, boy, I can't wait to read that. You know, the one thing you can say about our relationship, Asa, is that the good times actually outnumbered the bad times. And that made every minute of it worth it, didn't it? Didn't it, Asa?
Look, just take it easy, huh? I saw that photograph of your sister and her baby again.
What photograph?
The one you keep in your wallet?
What? You were looking through my wallet?
Look, I had to pay room service. My wallet was in the bedroom. I saw your purse right over here, so
So you decided to look in it? Why didn't you ask me?
I don't know. Why are you making such a big deal out of this?
I already told you this. My sister is a very sore subject with me. I mean, here we were toasting our partnership, and you bring up this name to me.
All right, just got it right. I wasn't thinking. Okay, I just said what came to my mind. As I recall, that's a quality of mine that you happen to admire. And look, I will never mention Carol and Millie again, even though I'm dying to find out why it makes you panic.
No, it is not panic. It is rage. Oh, God. I wish I never met you. I wish I never slept with you. I wish I never started this partnership with you. Oh, my God, you can't be trusted. You go snooping. You go sneaking around. You ask questions that are none of your business. Why are you trying to pry into my life?
Hold it! For crying out loud. Here. Take this and smash it over my body, all right? And then we can forget about this and get on with our lives. Here, I have sinned. I admit it. Please, punish me. So we can forget this.
If I had any sense, I would use that chair on you. I guess I don't have any sense.
Good. This sucker would hurt.
Oh.
Come on, I'm sorry. Maybe someday you'll want to tell me. Never mind, forget it. Look, we are lovers now. We are no longer casual acquaintances. Now, lovers trade stories. They talk about the good times and the bad. They share. Seems you have a little problem with the sharing.
Maybe I do. Maybe I don't. Before we start celebrating again, why don't you get Pamela and find out if we own this popsicle stand or not?
You convinced me to keep quiet because I thought that my son was going to be raised by two united, loving parents.
Well, he will be. You just have to have a little trust and faith.
Faith? At every turn, you've lied to me, Tina. First, you pretend that you're married to Max and that you and he will be raising my son. And when I get here, I find that's not the case at all. And that Max doesn't even know that this is his son. And furthermore, Cord doesn't even want you.
That's not true. Cord just needs... he needs a little time. Gabrielle, he thought I was dead, so he turned to Kate out of his grief.
Nonsense. Cord left you long before. That's why you went to Buenos Aires with Max.
It's not true. We were having some problems, okay? But it wasn't over or anything, and I knew once I came back with the baby...
The baby? Yes, it could have been any baby. It was my son that you used to win your husband back. You know, you said that you loved my son, you cared about his future, when all along it was your own future that you cared about. Well, it's over, Tina. I am not letting you use my son as a pawn any longer.
As you could see, Nurse Fields, there's nothing in room 3 to concern you.
Who is this patient, and why are there 2 guards here?
The prisoner was delirious from fever. We had to sedate him to keep him from harming himself.
Well, why didn't a nurse or a doctor take care of that?
Medical personnel are in short supply, as you well know. Well, shall we move along?
I'd like to examine the patient myself.
He has a contagious disease. Please stay away from him.
I'm a nurse, remember? Besides, you don't seem to have taken any precautions.
I think it best we moved along, Nurse Fields. You are making a grave mistake.
Patrick. God, it is Patrick.
The patient's name is Miles Bentley. He is an Australian. Please get away from his bed immediately.
His name is Patrick London. He is an American, and he was lost in the jungle 5 years ago.
Now, listen to
me. Let go of me.
I have been very considerate of your desires. This tour is now over. I think it best you moved along.
Don't you understand? This is a matter of mistaken identity. This man has been wrongly imprisoned.
It is you who are mistaken, Miss Fields. We have ascertained his identity. And my patience is running out. Now, do I have you removed from this room forcefully? Or will you come with me quietly?
Oh, I'll go. But the moment I get to the Capitol, I am consulting the American Embassy and your government. And there'll be an investigation about this, and I won't rest until this man is released. Patrick London will become an international incident, and you can count on that.
And what about your crime, Miss Sanders? Impersonating a nurse? And lying to me? Oh, yes, I know who you are.
Then you know that this isn't Miles Bentley, don't you? Well, why was he arrested? Who is behind all this?
You are traveling under false papers, Miss Sanders, and I am now placing you under arrest.
What? If you know who I am, then you also know that my father is Charles Sanders, an ambassador. And if I'm not returned, if I am harmed, Major,
you
then you can...
You will remain in this room, Miss Sanders, while I decide what to do with you.
Don't forget, Freedom International knows I'm here, too.
I have been going crazy wondering what your decision is going to be.
I'm going.
What?
I'm going with you to Austria.
Wait, you're going to go?
Yes.
I can't believe this.
Well, boy, am I glad I got that reaction.
I can't believe... I was sure you were going to say no. You really do love me, don't you?
If I didn't, we wouldn't be having this conversation. Anyway, I tried to tell my father that I need my independence. And if he doesn't give it to me, well, then I'm just going to have to take it.
Well, that's a big responsibility. I just want to make sure that you going to Austria with me isn't a mistake for you.
No, it's not. Anyway, we couldn't survive thousands of miles apart for so long.
Sorry I'm late.
Oh, please sit down. It's all right. I'm just so thankful that you could meet me this late at night. Professor Stapleton, I'm afraid this matter has become somewhat urgent.
I gave my colleague the drawing of the Argentinian crest on the pocket watch.
Mm-hmm.
As an expert on South American heraldry, it didn't take him long to discover what family the coat of arms symbolizes. It belongs to the Medina family of Argentina.
Now, just hold on a minute here. You're accusing me of a bunch of stuff that's just not true.
What stuff?
What? Trying to say that I don't love this baby. Oh, Gabrielle, I do love him. You know, I loved this baby from the minute I saw him, from the minute he was born, and I helped in his being delivered. Do you remember that? Look, you may be able to say a lot of bad things about me, okay, and maybe they're true, but you can't ever doubt my love for Al.
I doubt everything about you, Tina. I've been forced to.
All right, honey. I've had it just about up to here with all this self-righteous stuff here, okay? Now, you remember you were the one that risked this baby's life by going out to deliver him out in the jungle by not even going to a hospital. And you are also the one who's going to give up this wonderful little baby to complete, total strangers for adoption. All because you just happened to be just a little bit ashamed of him. And you are also the one who swore you would never interfere in his life. And look, here you are. Here you are making all sorts of demands and accusations. So don't you keep on playing the little Miss Perfect to me, all right?
I know I'm not perfect, Tina. But then again, neither are you.
That's true. But I am a wife fighting for my husband. And I am a mother fighting for my child. He is mine now. And you can't prove otherwise. Cords and my name are on the birth certificate. How can you prove he was yours? What, by a couple of Indian guys who just happened to see you were pregnant?
You are going to ruin my son's life. Do you think for 1 minute that I can let you keep him?
I am going to raise this child as a Buchanan. Don't you see that? He is going to have every advantage in life.
Tina, I don't care about all the material things that you can give him. I want my son to be raised in a stable home with love and security.
He will be. I love him. He will have that, and he'll have so much
Tina?
More.
Here you are.
All right, knock it off. There's no hand-holding allowed in here.
Who says?
Hi, Max.
The boss. At least I will be after Pamela signs the papers over to me. We trade signatures and all that stuff. Mary Lynn, word is that you are looking for a summer job. I happen to have some openings. How would you like to be a hotel management intern?
I would love to.
Great. Tomorrow morning, report to the personnel office. Check in. They'll set you up, all right?
Terrific. Thanks, Max.
You're
welcome. Don't know how much this means to me.
And me, too.
She's supporting you now or something?
Everything is falling into place for us.
Yo, how you doing, Grandma?
How are you doing, Godfather?
I am doing so good, I don't know where to start.
Neither do I. I was just wondering about Gabrielle Medina showing up in town the way she did.
Oh, yeah, we talked about that at church.
Yes, but, Max, when did Tina and Gabrielle have the opportunity to become so close when they were in Buenos Aires?
Well, they didn't, not unless they did it out of necessity when Jamie and Dante had them up at the falls. Why?
It just seems so strange. I don't know, it bothers me.
Maria, everything was strange down there, but that's all history now. There's nothing to worry about anymore. Got it?
I guess not.
You know what I think? I think you need a man in your life to get your mind off of other people's business. Then maybe, just maybe, you might quit getting messed up in other people's stuff where you don't belong.
Hey, son, how you doing, huh?
It's about time for you to go to sleep.
Cord, honey, where did you go during the party?
Well, that's what I need to talk to you about, Tina. In fact, I'd kind of like to talk to you in private. Gabrielle, that doesn't mean you have to split or anything, though.
Oh, well, Gabrielle was just leaving, weren't you?
No, I wasn't.
Well, I tell you what, we could go talk out in the hall. Of course, if you don't mind looking after my son for a little bit.
Of course she'd mind. I mean, well, that's such a big responsibility to ask Gabrielle all of a sudden.
Responsibility? Tina, we're just going to be outside and the child's just laying there.
I would love to look after him.
Thank you. Thanks. Tina?
Court, if this is about the divorce...
Well, actually, Tina, it is. I'm going to need to put the divorce on hold for a little while.
What?
I've got to go to Geneva. I have not heard word one from Kate since she left, and I am starting to get really worried.
Patrick.
Kate. Kate. Is it really you? Tell me I'm not hallucinating.
No, it's me. I can't believe you're real.
Found me. You finally found me. I knew someday he'd come. Oh, God, thank you. Thank you.
But I am. I'm already packed and have made my reservations.
What do you think you're doing?
Oh, I'm returning to a simpler way of life. I'm going to start helping people instead of taking money.
What about people? What about me? Am I so inconsequential to your life that you can just waltz in here and say goodbye with an aloha?
I told you how I felt over and over again. Now, the truth is, maybe you just didn't believe me.
No, I didn't. I didn't believe that our relationship was so meaningless that you could just leave without giving us some kind of chance to work it out.
Why stay? That's going to make the separation a lot more difficult.
Why go? Pam, move in with me. We can build a sane lifestyle here in Landview.
I can't, Pete. I love you. I adore you. But I belong in Malacava.
Being what? Schoolmarm? Spinster?
If that's what you want to call it.
What about me? What about us, ma'am?
You are the best thing that ever happened to me in Landview. And I will cherish every moment.
Will you stop it? You're talking like a greeting card. You're tearing my heart out, and you're talking as if I'm not going to miss you when you're gone.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to shock you or hurt you. It's certainly not fair for me to ask you to leave here, to leave your career and your dreams, and come to Malacava and be a school mom's old man with nothing more to do than just rebuild an island.
Pam, look, I know that you have to leave Landview. Do we have to leave civilization? Why can't we just go to California, huh? I can work there, you can work there.
I can't, Pete. It's my soul that's yearning to be home. Yearning for my people who need me, yearning for the island. And I'm not going to give up that need any more than you should give up yours.
What about love, Pam? What about the need that people have to have someone that loves them? Doesn't that count?
Oh, yes, that does count, but it's not a priority right now.
Pam, I swear to you, I honestly believe that we can make each other happy, that we can spend the rest of our lives doing that.
I know you can make me happy. I just don't think I can make... I don't think you'd be happy. I think you'd get restless on the island.
Why don't you let that be my choice?
Can you be packed by tomorrow morning?
I need time to think about that, Pam.
Fine. But tell you the truth, I've already thought about it a lot, and I think you're going to come to exactly the same conclusion I did. And that's, we have to let each other go now.
Got to answer that.
Okay. I'll be over at the inn, and you can find me there when you finish thinking.
Yeah. That's terrific. Okay, give Miss Gunnan a shield. Put him on the roster, all right?
Bad time, Commissioner? sorry that somebody just handed me an impossible situation. Any way I choose, I think I lose.
Cindy and I couldn't believe it.
But you recognize me.
Oh, yes. God, I can't imagine how much you've suffered.
No, you can't. But the worst part of it is I don't know why.
They think you're a man named Miles Bentley.
Oh, Kate, they know I'm not Miles Bentley. Those papers were just planted on me. The whole thing was a setup, an excuse to hold me here. They never even bothered to ask any questions. Just said I passed some state secrets or something. Just more mindless torture to occupy their miserable days, I guess.
Well, it's all over now, I promise you. I'm going to take you home to America.
Does home still exist? Is there such a place?
Yes. God.
You know, you're more beautiful than I even remember. Those thoughts I had about you. How much I love you. That's the only thing that kept me sane. It kept me alive.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I understand. Yes, immediately. Well, it seems that my future, as well as yours, depends on our preventing Miss Sanders from creating an international incident.
You mean we have to let him go?
Absolutely not. Oh, we'll escort them out of the compound, but once outside, there will be an unfortunate accident.
But I don't understand. If Cindy and Charles both said there's no problem...
Well, for some reason, Cindy was telling me an out-and-out lie, and I think Charles was, too. Now, even though he was trying to be real calm and tell me everything was fine, I could still sense a lot of tension in his voice.
Court, honey, I really kind of hate to bring this up, but I know how much you care about Kate, but did you ever think maybe there's another man involved?
Tina, please, not now, all right?
Well, it just makes sense. I mean, if she just ran off like that and you haven't heard from her.
I trust Kate, Tina. Listen, I don't know how long I'm going to be gone, but this is something I got to do, and I'll be back as soon as I can.
All right, you take as much time as you need. Al and I will be just fine, and we'll take care of the divorce when you get back. But right now, I should really get in there and see what's going on in the library.
Oh, okay, just a second, though. I never really had a chance to thank you properly for the baptism today. It was wonderful. Thank you.
Oh, look at you. Your eyes are opening. Oh, darling. And you don't even know who I am, do you? Or how much you mean to me. But I have to back down from Tina. My hands are tied. Because some way, somehow, your life is in danger. And if I take Tina to court, publicity alone is the last thing you need. I don't know why you're in danger, but your great-grandmother said you are, and I have to listen to her. But I promise you, my precious one, we will be together. We will, I promise you. Oh, how I want to pick you up and hold you, but I just don't think I'd be able to put you back down. You must stay here just for now, for your own sake. I could pick you up and just walk right out of here. Take you away from Landview. Probably no one would ever find us.
Stay and I can't leave.
Why can't you leave?
Now, come on, Ed. I'm not a beach bum. I mean, I just can't tear out of here on a moment's notice. Can I?
You really want to know what I think?
Yes, I do, eh?
Well, I had a love with my life. Just one. And I always put being a cop ahead of that. And then when I stopped being a cop, it was too late. There was too much time lost, too much... no time to grow together. I wound up losing the one thing, the one person that really counted.
It sounds like you're telling me to go with Pam to Malakava.